is, and what's your thoughts on it?
I think I've had the pleasure to really see K-pop develop as a very strong entity, musical entity. And I think the international attention that it's been getting is proof of that. When I first started out, artists in Korea had this vague idea, notion of trying different genres and maybe imitating Western genres that they hear. The biggest difference now is that they've not only imitated, but they've surpassed, they've mastered. And within K-pop itself, there are very, very specific genres. There are very amazingly talented independent artists, as well as K-pop stars like Spica and AOA and MIB. They really show the international community a different level of commitment to their music and to their stage. As for me, I've just had the pleasure of seeing that evolution as an artist. Oh, I never had dreams of being in a girl group. It would be nice to have been, just because I love the camaraderie that I see between being in a team. As you can see today, I'm the only one that's alone. So it's kind of nice to have that teamwork, to be part of a group. I see members gathering strength from each other. So in that sense, I would have loved to, but unfortunately, I'm a horrible dancer. So even if I wanted to, I don't think anybody would have picked me up. My listening tastes are so varied. I started out in gospel music. I also sang a little bit of jazz at one time. I do enjoy rock music a lot. So in my albums, I try to just reflect my listening tastes in the music that I do. So although I am more well-known for traditional ballads, the fact that I do like to try different genres of music was, I think, best expressed in the I Am a Singer competition. On any given album or on any given concert, I will go from a ballad to a punk rock song to something jazzy to something else. And I guess I was finally able to show that to wider audiences. But yes, I have always tried to stretch myself and be as versatile as I possibly could. Sometimes you fail, and sometimes you succeed, but I think the importance was trying. So I'm just still trying to find new things to do. Lately, I've been listening to a lot of Korean independent hip-hop and rap, and I think that area is really, really growing. So a collaboration with upcoming hip-hop stars would be really interesting. There are a lot of artists. It's hard to single out one, because I do just change my listening taste from day to day. I would love to collaborate with any of the artists sitting here next to me today. Lena Park or Park Jung-hyun and MIB, that would be an interesting song. Park Jung-hyun and Spica, they'll dance for me, or they'll teach me how to dance. That would be an interesting collaboration. Especially Jung Jae-deok Shi and Park Ju-won Shi. It's always been a dream of mine. I have done performances with Jung Jae-deok. And if we did a collaboration, that would be something that'd be really exciting. It'd be something that I think I can learn a lot of experience from. I have one song prepared that was actually released here in Singapore the last time I was here too, was to promote it. I don't know if anybody remembers it, but I have prepared that song, and it's called In Dreams, 꿈에 in Korean. That song, it seems like I can't go anywhere without singing it, or else people will get mad at me. So I always prepare it. But also, because it is a very diverse festival, I wanted to bring some more, you know, different genres to the table, like the young lady asked before. So I do have a couple rock songs from albums prepared. And I have, for the international community, prepared many English language songs, a couple from my own albums that I wrote, and also a nice standard cover that a lot of people will enjoy and everybody will like. In terms of being an international festival singer, I do want people to be able to relate to at least the lyrics. So I've prepared kind of a varied, diverse little set.